Alrighty. I'm gonna double check and see if my stream is up and going.
It is not.
Well, it should be. My channel?
There we are.
Alrighty. Well. No. Alright, so it is live. Woohoo! Yay! Alright, so. Well, what? Alright guys, this is what I gotta do. I tried to get everything to fire up before and it wouldn't do it, so sorry about that before. I know it said I went live and then I had a welcome to trying to get everything going on a live stream broadcast. Or live stream broadcast, I should say, not live stream or live sim, whatever I said before.
Live stream simulator 2016.
I don't know if you guys hear him or not.
Priest. Hey. Priest.
Is that your dog?
Yeah. Barking at something in his sleep. He was, boy, he was letting him know about it too.
Oh, that's adorable.
I'm trying to get to you. Oh, I hear myself.
Sorry about that.
I'm trying to. Yep. Alrighty. I'm just going to go ahead and load in my Murica truck.
That I can't see.
Yep. Alrighty, so I don't know if you got my stream pulled up?
Mm-hmm.
The cam, is it good enough on? I figured the wheel is just a wheel and people are going to watch it spinning. I figured people would be more interested in the shifting.
Well, the whole thing is a little choppy for me, but I don't know if that's just my internet taking a poop or not. If some of the guys that are in the chat could verify how the stream is looking.
I'm wondering if that's the deal. Let me double check something. I'm going to go ahead and quit real quick. I'll be back in just a second. I think I may have boo-booed. No? Okay. Well, that's not up. Quit that. You're too loud.
Are you on the right server?
Europe too.
Interest in London?
Yeah, I just saw you.
I don't see you.
I know, I just signed out and signed back in.
Okay.
I got out and came back in. Alrighty. So guys, for everybody watching, yeah, game change detected, I know. Alrighty, so, signing into Europe 2. Alrighty, let's fire the truck up again. Me and my Scania.
Oh, I'm jealous of that wheel.
Yeah, I like it pretty well. Oh, there you are. So where are we gonna go? Oh, there it is. So where are we gonna go out of London?
Let's find out.
All right.
Well, freight market. Freight nothing. Market. Come on.
I got all kinds of stuff in the freight market. You did reset yourself, yeah?
Yeah, let me double check it.
You reset the right profile, yeah?
I only have one for ETS.
Oh, well, that would explain it. Because I'm seeing out of London, Munchen, salt, going to Munchen, 19 tons of it. Here's a good one, 25 tons to Carlisle. That's...
All right, set that back to zero, and hopefully...
You put it to one, and then launch the game.
I mean, it was already on one. That's how I'm in London.
Oh, well. Because I've got three pages of stuff.
We are never short on technical difficulties.
Oh, no. I hear something backing up.
All right. Let's try this again. Job market. Still nothing. Come on. I guess it's external contract for me.
Alrighty. Where you want to go on external contract? It doesn't bother me. Just make sure that I don't speed. There's...
Oh. Stockholm?
Eh, why not? You want fluorine or nitrocellulose?
I'll go with the cellulose.
Alrighty. Well, oh, poo. I gotta abandon a, hang on a second. F7, F3. Currently have no delivery job. Well, okay. Abandon that and then go back to fluorine to Stockholm. Woohoo! There it is. Woohoo! Alrighty, I'm ready when you are.
All right, let's go. With these trucks that love to fly.
Make sure you get on the left-hand side of the road.
Yep. Way ahead of you this time.
Oh, you're blinking.
Of course.
I hit the wrong gear.
Of course.
Yep. I got used to driving American truck sim. The American truck sim, I... You know, do the 18 Eaton Fuller, and go from there. So, alrighty. Are you going for the far one? Because I got the yellow one in the middle.
I think we're in the same spot.
Isn't that just something peachy? I'll go ahead and pull up mirrors for everybody else that's watching. And you can't see my mirrors. Oh, I missed that bigger than hell. Nope, I missed it again. Oh, I just drug the kingpin over the back wheels. Oops.
Oh, good thing it's not sharp.
Oh. I missed. Jeez. I just need to give up.
Hmm.
Reset, restart, just either that or get the hell out of the way so you can get in here.
Take your time.
There it is. Finally. Tug test and yieldy first gear. Yep, it works. Oh, yeah. So I've got a white one. I got a white one. I don't know if anybody ever listened to Jeff Foxworthy talk about the Atlanta Olympics.
Oh, Foxworthy.
When they let the doves go, there'd be some redneck in the parking lot with a 12-gauge. I got a white one.
Oh, crooked as everything.
Oh, yeah. Classic. I'm going to let everybody see my America truck.
Well, I'm glad they can see it.
Well, you can too.
Is that... Did I get it?
Yeah. Go.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Right hand turn out of the yard here. Look left. Don't see anybody. Nobody coming from the right. We're good.
Make sure we get in the proper lane.
Yep. I'm working on that as we speak. I'm probably handling this roundabout the way wrong way, but no traffic, no cop, it's good.
No stop.
And there it is. I actually don't need that GPS up because I've got one in a windshield. I love that add-on pack.
It's pretty nice.
Yes.
But it got to the point where I had so many items with physics in my cab that it was killing my frames.
I've got a little Scania truck, and I've got a little bobblehead dog. It's actually kind of cute.
I think the Scania truck might be a different DLC, because I don't have that option.
It's funny, because when I hit the brakes, the cab of that truck goes all over the place. I got my phone on my dash. Well, not my phone. It's an Apple. I wouldn't own an Apple anything.
Never.
Personally. Not an Apple fan. Oh, crap, speeding. Oh. These things are like missiles. I mean, they just...
Yeah.
They go.
Oh, you want to go 5 miles an hour? Let's do 50.
Pretty much. So I'm... 11th gear.
11th gear, 50 miles an hour.
And split to 12th.
You might want to get in the next lane.
Yeah, I'll work on it. Alrighty. I think I can do this in 10th. I think I can do it in 10th.
Little truck that could.
Mm-hmm. Nope, 9th it is. And away we go. 60 miles an hour. Whee! So, Beans, you play ETS on one monitor, and I can't figure out how to make my phone see my YouTube chats.
Mm-hmm.
How many we got? what's up and who all's there?
Looks like 15 people watching.
Outstanding. Hi, 15 people. Like I said, that's the drawbacks of having the trucker setup that I have is when I'm doing stuff from the truck, unless I have another computer up, I'm not going to see what you say. So Manly's kind of my eyes on that end of things.
Yeah, and it's kind of, I need to pull it off on my second monitor because right now it's on my laptop that I have to turn my head 90 degrees to look at.
Yeah, YouTube moderating, live stream moderating, and driving are not not condoned.
I'd say that's worse than texting and driving.
Oh yeah, so much worse.
Maybe a little bit.
That's funny.
But just a little.
Like I said, I'm curious how these trucks are actually set up, because watching that, the bobblehead truck on my dash is having a field day. I mean, it is straight up all over the place. And this was like 1,200 miles, give or take. So it'll probably be this load for the live stream, and then that's going to be it. But I wanted to at least show you guys that I got a toy. This is why I'm spending as much time in Truck Sim as I have been lately. Really, really kind of fired the passion back up for that game. Like I said, if you can afford it, it's an awesome, awesome investment.
It's surprisingly very worth the money.
Oh, yeah. And like I said before, that's kind of what I'm thinking about the rail driver that I talked about in the LSPDFR episode that released today. Was, oh crap, 50. And speed cameras. Anyhow, what I was getting at is, I think if I got an actual cab controller for like a train engine, then it would make Train Sim that much more real McCoy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's all kinds of stuff you can do with a controller, don't get me wrong. But when it comes to having the right hardware for the right sim.
I think it was the Northern Alex I watched do a review on some kind of train sim controller a while back, and it looked pretty cool. I have to go back and see if I can find that for you.
Was it the same one that Jeff did a while back? Maybe. Jeff has got a rail driver. It's got like 32 buttons and a D-pad down along the face, and then you've got like two different brake levers, a reverser lever, all kinds of real McCoy things. About busted up a guardrail, didn't you?
No, about busted your trailer.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, Charlie.
You had a little lag spike there.
Oh. Not on my screen. The manly moan. I'm pretty sure we're doing about 65. Nope, 55. External contract.
Locked at 55 in ETS anyway.
Yeah, that's the drawback to ETS, but once you get the expansion packs, the DLC, man, you want to talk about a huge world to discover. I'm having all kinds of fun, especially driving from the opposite side of the truck, opposite side of the road, whole nine yards, weird street signs. Well, not weird, but, unfamiliar. I'm a little more familiar than most people with them, just because I have lived abroad. We're in Harwich, and it's a 30.
Yep, I'm just hanging out with the rumble strip back here.
Going to this roundabout at warp 8.
Yeah, I'm not doing that this time. This was the one I messed up in yesterday, I think.
Yeah, before you know, and the ferries. I mean, this is kind of cool. I mean, ferry, you got the channel tunnel, you got the ferries, you got
speeding offense,
trains, and all kinds of neat stuff.
Oh, red light. No.
You're welcome.
I'll get you back later.
Oh, I just shorted that corner bigger than hell. Possible destinations to Europort. Rawr.
And yeah, guys, to those that were wondering in the chat, it was lag on the game server, not Runt's recording.
Yeah, that's one thing. I mean, it's a multiplayer server, so the sync is, it's going to have issues every now and then, and that's just, nobody can tell that I'm an American playing Euro Truck right now, for sure.
You'd never be able to tell with me.
My, faux vector, amber lights across the top of it.
Yep, sorry, I heard a Discord noise. It distracted me.
Oh, no problem.
Oh, it's raining.
Clear, bright, sunny day for me. That's another thing that the server doesn't quite get right, is weather across the server. And I don't know what the deal there is.
Can't handle AI traffic either.
Oh, I don't want it to handle AI traffic. AI traffic is almost as bad as other drivers usually.
Well, it'd make our videos a lot funnier.
Oh, mine are hilarious. Well, my offline sessions with you and Shock has been hanging out with us quite a bit.
Distress call.
Pretty hey, much. What's up, Shock?
Notch. Came in here and you guys were talking about something and I was like, oh, maybe I should wait until a good opportunity to speak.
No, you're welcome, buddy. Oh, yeah. I can't find it, grind it.
So you guys are playing Euro Truck?
Yeah, but if you're here, we might jump in and do some American Truck on a Euro Truck night or something.
I'm kind of debating that. I mean, I'd have to re-downgrade because I upgraded back to do the
yep, and the whole DLC thing as well.
Yeah, I had to do that.
So, well, if you... we've got a minute, so
yeah.
Well, I was about to say, I mean, if you want to do ATS, I can do it. It's no problem.
Yeah, we'll do ATS as soon as we drop this one off. We'll jump over and play both of them. I want to show people. I don't know if you know it, Shock. I'm actually live streaming this ETS run. With kind of a wheel cam, more of a shifter cam, on my new 27.
Oh, yeah. And, I saw the notification actually, and I didn't think much of it.
Yep, and actually, Shock, could you go, if you wouldn't mind, being our eyes and ears for the chat?
Oh yeah.
I don't know about that one.
Oh, lag.
No, that wasn't lag. That was my brakes.
No, my game was lagging. ETS loves to lag on my end.
No, I was I was in the brakes with both feet. I was very much in the brakes with both feet trying to find the gear. And I'm going off of muscle memory where the actual gears are.
How's that going for you?
Well, I almost caused a wreck.
So, not good.
Yeah, it's, oh, yeah, I forgot. They're doing construction here, and I just, yep, blew their doors off.
Yeah, I'm doing 55. Oh, there's an admin nearby.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Oops.
Is that guy a cement mixer? The hell? How do you get Whoa. That truck?
That was interesting.
My internet is just being a twit right now. I don't know what's been going on, but I've been having issues for the past week. Actually, almost 2 weeks now. The fuck? I think Discord's gonna die again. Because you guys just literally went silent for like 20 seconds.
No, I'm focusing on my driving. I'm entering another tunnel waiting for the sudden speed drop from 50 miles an hour to 30.
Yeah.
Just bingo bango, done.
Usually when Discord goes quiet for 10 seconds or more, it means it's about to give me the ye olde, death.
Gives you a le boot.
Yeah, it just gives me a doo-doo, and I'm like, crap.
Ah, crap.
Yeah, it's a pain.
Oh, but no. Poor dog on my dash. He's got a broken neck.
Alright, I'm gonna get the chat pulled up. I popped it out so that I can have it a little bit easier.
Oh, yeah, your truck layout is different from mine. The interior, anyway.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. I don't have that little raised island section right next to the console.
Yeah. Yep. Oh, shit. Yeah, I'm listening to you guys. I'm just trucking on through Amsterdam. Going for broke.
Internet is just dumping itself right now.
Yeah. Yep. I knew it was coming. Speeding what is defense.
It? Oh, shoot. That is... Yep, there's mine. I do it every... We've been through Amsterdam 6 times, and I do it every time.
I was just cruising around along.
Right, I do it every time. Oh, and I'm 2,500 RPMs.
Okay, is chat even happening, or is my internet about to... crap itself.
C, all of the above.
Yeah. Oh, I think all pretty much all that happened last night. I get home, it's about 5 o'clock in the afternoon here, and all of a sudden just internet just dead, and I'm like, what happened? And apparently someone around here, you know, disconnected something and ruined it all.
Digging a hole.
No, I mean, there was conduit laying going on around here, so yeah.
I forget who was saying to me the other day that they're getting fiber.
It is me.
Oh no, never mind. Ghost Rider. Ghost Rider was saying he's fiber.
Oh yeah.
Oh, he is.
But he's not fiber to his house. He's basically fiber to the D-Slam, and then. So right now the hardware in the D-Slam is what's you know, his holdup.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry for those of you that, oh shoot.
Do.
That that was the wrong time to take a drink of fresh soda.
Oh no!
Distress call.
Pretty much.
Or no, it's not distress call anymore. It's Mayday.
Mainly Mayday. Yep, the mainly Mayday.
That's great.
And then we also have the Runt Grunt.
The Runt Grunt. Yep.
Yep. Is what somebody coined today when I was messing around.
Courtesy of a lost guy.
Yeah, a lost guy. Yeah, the Runt Grunt.
Yep.
So. Yep. It's, I'll never forget the first night. And people aren't going to see it because I wasn't recording it. I just wanted to get on a Euro truck and try it out with you guys. And mainly taking a left and going down the right-hand lanes in London. And then realizing it's... Oh, crap. Good thing there's no traffic.
Hey, yeah, I wish I had recorded that.
Would have been pretty fantastical.
Although I do have a decent collection of outtakes now. Just from our random runs.
Oh, yeah. Well, that guy last night just aggravated the fire out of me.
Oh.
Driving like shock, loses it going around a corner, and face plants the cab of his truck into a wall.
And then,
I've got me, I've got Manly behind me, and then the truck behind Manly. There's a car and a truck coming up the hill on the other side where the guy lost it. I'm coming at him thinking he's been sitting there for, I don't know, 10 seconds. I guess he was trying to figure out how to get his truck started or try to shake the cobweb loose from the hit or whatever. He throws his truck in reverse and backs up, and I hit him in the driver's door, and the car hits him in the tail end. The truck hits the car, Manly hits me, and the truck behind Manly hits him.
And then everybody just lays on the horn.
A horn fest.
Oh, yeah. It was, and I'm just thinking to myself, what kind of idiot? You know, yeah, I'll admit it. I've driven like an idiot in Euro truck, in American truck, just on a regular, you know, freight load, just drop the hammer and go for broke, you know? But if I lose it and I see other traffic coming, I'll wait until they're clear before I start trying to get my, basically clean my pickle off. You know, I'm just, wow. Yeah, some people's kids, I don't know. Now, we were talking, I think it was Bloke was talking, and for those of you guys know that know Bloke, he's back in the UK now. We were unsuccessful of trying to find him a wife or his green card. So, anyway, he was saying that in as far as Euro Truck goes, for the most part, the people that play Euro Truck don't have a license in real life. So they have no idea what it's like to drive on a real road.
As he said, they either A, don't drive, or B, are drunk.
Yeah, well, yeah, I forgot that. I forgot B. People are intoxicated while they're playing Euro Truck.
Yep. Okay, I don't know if I should connect my TV or not.
Oh, texting and driving.
We got somebody in the chat.
Well, see, I can't, if I'm going to play, I need to have another screen so I can see the chat.
Oh, no. I mean...
But
let's see. I'm trying to remember buttons.
It's dead in the chat.
Yeah, we've got 800 miles to go, so.
Oh boy.
Yeah, you got time, brother.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that real quick. See if I can figure out where the port is on the back of my computer.
You got time. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, rip me.
Well, actually, 800 miles minus, I think it's like 150 or 300 miles. Because we've got another ferry to grab onto. 25 miles an hour. 40 kph, for those of you that don't know. 40 kph is 25 miles an hour.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, bouncy, short wheelbase truck.
Oh, no. Almost messed it up.
All right, this is something one of you two are going to remember this, because I won't. I've got too many gray hair to remember much. Wrong gear. I stuck it in a hole that there wasn't a gear there.
Giggity.
Yeah. Thanks. You're throwing me off. I just saw a circular white sign with diagonal black stripes. Not a solid diagonal black stripe, but multiples. I don't know if it's a real sign or if it was just the way the game looked coming around it, because I was going pretty good.
Oh, it's a 50, not a 60.
We got 55. That's about it.
I'm just straddling the crap out of the line here.
Oh, taking your half out of the middle, huh?
Yep. I just decided I wanted the whole road, so here I am.
Yeah, like I said, I kind of feel bad. I've got, you know, a 6-speed gear shifter with reverse and all that. And in ETS, I use first through third, and that's it. Because the way I've got the transmission set up for range and split, you only use, 12 gears. And yes, you can get 12 gears out of 3 holes. And that just sounds odd.
Yep.
Okay, that took way longer than it should have. There is so much stuff, so much random junk on my desk.
Yeah, Runt, you got a lot of people saying hi to you in the chat if you want to explain your monitor setup.
Oh, yeah, I would love to say hi to people. That's why Manly's here with me. He's basically my eyes as far as text chat goes. Because my monitors, when I play Euro Truck or American Truck, my monitors are all active.
You got a guy flying up on the right. Watch out for him.
All right. I'm looking in the mirror. I see him coming over. Matter of fact, here. I'm going to move over to where you guys can see. There's what I see out of my right mirror, or my right screen. And then there's center again, and then left. Woo. Trying to keep it on the straight. Keep it on the straight and narrow. I'll go back to my natural view, because this guy is all over the damn road.
About to kill somebody. Hey, what's up, Ghost Rider?
Is he in the chat?
Yep.
Hey, guys.
What's going on? Yeah. Welcome to an impromptu live stream.
Sweet! You staying between the guardrails?
Nope. Between the guardrails, yes. Between the lines, not so much.
Oh, hey, you got the G27 up on the screen. That's awesome.
Yeah, I got ye olde gear shift up. I figured it'd be more interesting people watching how I shift versus watching the wheel. Yeah.
I think that's a good call.
Because, if I had to SKRS, I could show people a little bit more about how it's done. But it's basically the same. Like, right here, I'm in 12th gear. It means I'm actually in 11th, split to 12th. So I'm in high range, 11th gear, split. If that might make sense to somebody. And then again, I'm not a real truck driver. I do know one, though.
Unfortunately, he's not here.
Yeah, I know. That'd be interesting. And he's never driven 18, but he loves a 13. I have talked to him about it when Chip came to my house. We were talking, and I basically sat down because I was talking to him about wanting to get the SKRS, which I do. I just ran out of money. That the SKRS, you know, how I understand range, high low, but I didn't understand the splitter, and I didn't understand how reverse worked. I didn't understand, you know, your two lows. That stuff, I just didn't get it. But that's, now I get it, because I've got the front two buttons, or the first two buttons, the red buttons. The first one is my range, whether I'm in high range or low range, which is basically you walk through all the basement gears, and then get up to the top gears, and then your splitter is the button on the side, or I use this second button. I don't know if you can see my finger brushing around on it or not, but that button there is my splitter. So now what's neat about a splitter, and I've talked to people that drive truck, Chip is one of them, that like here, if I want to go into 11th gear, I push that button, and because I'm still on the throttle, I'm still in 12th gear, but I've basically pulled the splitter button back, and if I get off the throttle and back into throttle, I just shift it to 11th gear. So, and it stays in 11th gear. You don't have to clutch or anything. It's just pneumatic and synchronizers. So I'm in 11th gear. I'm going to get off the gas and go to 12th, and there I am again. So, and from my understanding, that's how the real ones work. You just got to, you know, get off the gas for a second and hop back on it, and it'll go and go the gear that you wanted to with the splitter button, what you're telling it to do with the button. So.
Man, 18. I have to take off my shoes to get up to 18, count up to 18.
Believe it or not, 18, I've gotten to where, unless it's a stupid heavy load, I've gotten to where I start out in third, which is basically back, basically straight down. It basically, third gear is high second, or low second, I'm sorry. Low second is third gear. I'll go from third gear to low fourth gear, so that's seventh gear. So third to seventh, and then shift gears, or shift ranges, and go from seventh to ninth, and then from ninth to 11th, and then 11th to 13th, or I'm sorry, anyway, I skip gears unless it's really heavy, because all you do then is wrap it out, you know, wrap it out and shift.
But if you're nowhere. going uphill, you may need them all, but right. Not flatland.
Alrighty. Sorry to interrupt, but we've got somebody, I can't see their name in the chat, asking what the point of this is.
The point of this is just kind of goofing around, having fun. Say I'm in 10th right now. I'll go ahead and go to 8th. And I'm more around the 25 mile an hour range where I wanted to be. And I'm going to go ahead and split. And I should be in 9th. And go ahead and bounce up to 11th. And splitter button is ready for when I get up to speed again. Get off gas, 12th gear. Now, the point of this was just because I got the G27 in. Other than that, I was using an old Microsoft Sidewinder, believe it or not. It actually works with the game. I was looking around when I was looking at this G27. Somebody had a Sidewinder on eBay for like $20. It works. It's 270 degree wheel. It's not a 900 like this one. Right turn coming up. Well, anyway, that's the point of this is, you know, I'm having fun with the new peripheral device that I got. And I wanted to bring you guys along for the ride more than anything.
Silius is asking how much this setup was.
I found my G27 on eBay for $250. Now, I say that because $250 is a significant amount of money, but it's still cheaper than the 29, which is the new stuff. This is a refurb. Refurb for 250, I think, is a fair price. But I found a G27 refurb, just like this was, for 200 the other day on eBay. So they're out there. You just got to be patient enough to find the right deal.
There are some that, if you're willing to wait, go on auction for as low as like $70.
Right. Well, if you find them.
You find them, and if you're lucky enough to not be outbid.
Right. Well. But yeah, it's. I will say this. It changed the game very much for me. Going from keyboard to controller, and then controller to that Sidewinder that is my buddy's, and then from that to this, is like crawl, walk, run. Manly's actually seen where I'm able to take roads that you can't with a controller at speed, because the wheel turns so slow. At speed, because the wheel, I'm able to, you know, hop mm-hmm. around pretty quickly. And I have the wheel turns with me. So. And fine control is so much better. It's easier to back up. Whole nine yards. But, yeah, it's fantastic. And, oh, Ghost Rider, that comment that you left on my LSPDFR video today, about mileage, you guys would call in mileage with a female.
Yeah.
We called in mileage on everybody. And it's mainly, again, to reiterate, as far as my experience goes, and you got to remember, my experience was 12 years ago, but I can't see this really changing that much. It goes Miranda versus Arizona. Because if you ever read the brief on Ernesto Miranda and what happened to him, why we have rights that are guaranteed to us. We always did, but Miranda versus Arizona was the Supreme Court case that guaranteed it. Basically, I want to say it was some kind of podunk somewhere in Arizona ended up, they were looking for a guy who had raped a young girl, and they picked up Ernesto Miranda, and ended up Ernesto Miranda had nothing to do with the price of tea in China, according to their case, but they needed to get somebody, so they took him and held him and, you know, beat him, whatever else they had to do to get him to confess to that crime. And you're not allowed to do that. That's why when you invoke your Miranda rights, all questioning stops. If it doesn't, then it's completely inadmissible. Because the police aren't doing their job right, A. And B, it also stems back to when you're transporting somebody, you call in your mileage, that way they can't say, well, he took me off and, you know, he beat me into saying that I did this. Or, you know, whatever else. And they can't go back and say, they can't go back and say later that, you know, oh, Officer Runt took me out and raped me or whatever else. So it's a protection for both sides of the fence, really.
Pior que essa porra às vezes desaparece.
Oh,
né?
Good lord.
Quando você abre, já vai para a última da fila.
Yeah, and we had it for the, I mean, of course, back then, The concern was primarily females complaining against the male crew, but for the same reason, yeah. Well, I mean, not for the Miranda, not for the legal end of it, but the... Somebody reporting an assault or something like that.
Right, well, now, contrary to popular belief, as a police officer, about searching people, everybody thinks that if they're a woman and they're stopped by a male officer, that male officer can't touch them, that male officer can't search them. Bull crap. When it comes down to officer safety, we're all taught how to invasively search somebody. So basically, if you're searching a woman, you do everything with the back of your hand. That way they can't say that you were, you know, cupping their bosom or whatever else. So, now, if we had a female officer on, would I call that female officer to come search a female? Yes. Just because. It's a kind of a compassion thing, kind of a trust thing. Me, I'm not too touchy-feely about it. If a woman wants to grab me and check me out, all right, cool. But, you know, women aren't quite as friendly as that. Now, I say that jokingly. I mean, do I go out and, you know, fool around and try to get women to grab me? No. But you guys see what I'm getting at, though. Women are a little more touchy when it comes to a man, men. Some men don't feel comfortable having a woman touch them. Whatever. So if the case presented itself, and you know it wasn't a, you know, immediate danger situation, like, you know, if it's just a normal, hey, I think you're drunk, then yeah, I'd call it. If we had a female officer on, then I'd call them and they'd come, you know, search the female. If it was a firearms incident, no, all bets are off. I'm searching you. It's an officer safety issue. Period.
Well, yeah, in a lot of smaller departments, you didn't have a female on every shift available.
No, I mean, the first department I ever worked for, we had a total of 6 out of 38 officers. So.
Yeah, and Ron, I don't know, are you watching the chat at all, or should I call out the folks that are joining?
I can't see the chat because I'm on all 3 of my monitors.
Yeah, no problem. I'll call them out as they join in. Smooth7 just joined, said he's been watching for 6 months.
Oh, fantastic. 6 months. I didn't even realize that I haven't been doing this for 6 months. I've only been doing this for about 2 months.
Well, maybe it just seems like 6 months. Yeah.
Tell me about it. As fast as I grew after the shout out by Jeff, it really feels like I've accomplished a lot more than I really have.
Mikel Rose is saying hi, Ron. It's Kel Rose 1 from Discord.
Oh, outstanding. Like I said, if you guys are saying hi to me on Discord and stuff like that, Discord, I'm actually using Twitch to get this game footage up. So, I can't see Discord, and it's not going to notify me, because as soon as I bring up XSplit, it puts Discord into streamer mode. So, I'm not getting notifications, I'm not... none of that. It's all about what I see in front of me right now.
I'm reading off of YouTube.
Oh yeah, that's great. One of these days, like I said, Ghost Rider, you've come along with us for enough of these, you know, after hour rides that you're gonna be buying American and Euro truck here pretty soon, and you'll be getting a wheel of your own. Trailborg.
We're coming up to the port.
Yep, I'm at the port. Rawr. Yep, I am in Trailborg, and I'm getting the right gear. So, if you guys are watching the gear shift, I'm gonna actually split all the gears and everything this time, so you see what I'm talking about. I'm actually gonna pull forward far enough and kick those on.
Yeah, it's kind of funny. I glance over at your stream every now and then, and with the input lag, basically, of the stream from...
Yeah, it's basically, you know, my truck is where yours is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, Trollborg?
Yes, sir.
On my way?
So this is going to get interesting with me actually going to try to hit every gear as I'm going. And I will say that if you actually drop the clutch without, if I tried to take off in third gear right here, and I just drop the clutch with no gas, game over, truck dies.
All right, so Connor Williams made it a comment about the white stripes, the sign with the white stripes.
Oh, okay.
He says it means end of good vehicle restrictions.
Oh, what does that mean? All right, so Manly, are you there yet?
Yep.
All right, I'll see you behind me.
And so, it finally stopped raining.
Here's first gear, 1500 RPM. Split to second. Split, go to third. Split, go to fourth. Split, go to fifth. Now, and then split to sixth. And then split again, go to high range, seventh. Well, like I said, it's with the button configuration, it's really hard to do. With a split, go to eighth. Split, go to ninth. And then tenth with just a splitter. I'm going to hit the splitter button.
Connor commented again, said it means height and width restrictions.
Oh, okay, height and width. Okay, that makes sense. And there's 11th. And then 12th. So, you can imagine with a splitter up here next to my thumb and a range selector. Oh, crap. Off ramp. With a splitter and a range selector up in the front of the shifter. It'd be a whole lot easier than trying to reach down and find buttons that you can't see because you're watching the road and everything else.
With all those different speeds, they'll come in handy when you're trying to tune it for best mileage, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, what's your mileage at right now, anyway?
Let's see. 47 liters to the 100 mile.
Wow, I'm at 61.
Yep. And I'm basically idling going downhill, so I'm 0 liters to 100 miles at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Until I get in it.
Helix 2-4 came on and said hi, and he says he's watching from the hospital, so man, I hope you get better.
Oh, no kidding. Hopefully nothing too serious.
And Jonathan Jones was giving us some information about in Ohio. It seems like where he has in his jurisdiction, there's always a female on duty, so they require a female search, unless, like you said, it's a firearms urgent officer safety issue.
Well, and like I said, 12 years ago, I hate to say it like this, but 12 years ago, female officers were few and far between.
Mm-hmm.
I have a friend of mine that was. Well, actually, it's a friend of my wife's, was one of the first females in police work in the country, in Miami Beach.
Hmm.
So, kind of trailblazer in that aspect.
Oh, yeah, they were real pioneers.
So.
John O'Neill says, love your videos, dude.
Outstanding. I love reading comments. I just here lately, I know it doesn't seem like I've been putting out a whole lot, and I'll tell you, the 11th of September is usually my day where I record my Monday LSPDFR and edit it and get it uploaded ready to go out on Monday. And the 11th of September is a day that I felt personally that it was more important to just hang out with friends and family and that kind of stuff than do a video. Just hang out and enjoy company. That's kind of, you know, can't believe it was 16 years ago. And Ghost Rider, you and I talked about that quite a bit, that people 16 years of age or younger have no recollection of that day. Even people that are 17 to 20, I would say, they may remember bits and pieces, but not, you know.
Yep, I was 5. So I don't remember too much about it.
Yeah, I mean, most of the younger folks remember the you know, the stuff they see on the memorial, that on their anniversaries, but not the actual day of.
Right. Well, I remember in 86, February of 86, very well. I can tell you where I was standing. You know what I'm talking about there. 86. Oh, come on,
go. I'm doing the math in my head.
Wasn't that the Challenger explosion?
Yes, sir.
That would have been a Challenger.
Yep.
Yeah, I can too. I remember exactly where I was.
Oh, I'm sorry. It wasn't February. It was January. January 29th or 28th. 29th, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, we were wheeling a patient into the hospital on a transfer. And as we passed by the monitors, they were just, you know, just going through the announcements of it.
Well, I lived on the West Coast at that time. So I was just entering my elementary school. And we had to take $1.10 in every day to buy a lunch ticket. That way they didn't have to worry about cash during lunch for us. Anyway, I was standing in line with the one lunch lady that was taking everybody's money and handing us our lunch ticket to and she was listening to it on the radio when the Challenger blew up. That wasn't nearly as shocking as September 11th, but it's a day that I will always remember. It's like my mother. My mother can tell you where she was in November of 1963.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I actually watched a show on that title one time. It was called 4 Days in November.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that.
It was a documentary about the JFK assassination and the aftermath and everything else. So, I mean, dates like that will stick out to you, for sure.
Yeah, King Turnell comments that he was 10 that day and he was pulled out of school because his mom was working in Manhattan and that she was in danger.
Oh, wow. Mm. Well, Sneaky Fox, maybe some of you guys know him. He's been in, he was in one of my Cunning Stunts videos, where we were racing, and come to find out, he said over Twitter that he was actually in one of the nurseries at the World Trade Center, and had been evacuated.
Wow.
So, I mean, it's interesting. Hearing people's stories and their reactions and what they were doing and everything else. I was in the service when that happened. I was actually in ANOC when that happened. I don't know if anybody else, Ghost Rider, might be familiar with that term.
Nah, it's not coming up.
Advanced Non-Commissioned Officers Course.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sorry. Yep.
I was... I was a 6, going to school to learn how to be a 7. Which was funny because I never made 7. I was actually on my way out the door. My first sergeant come up to me and says, hey, Sergeant, I need to talk to you. I said, yeah, okay, what's up? He says, have you looked at the Army Times? I'm like, nope, I'm A-capping. I'm getting the hell out. He says, well, you need to look. I'm like, no, I don't. He's like, well, the 7 list came out today. I'm like, yeah, and? He says, well, you know somebody, I guarantee you know somebody on the list. I'm like, yeah, I do too. Our MOS is about the size of a thimble. You know what I mean? And ended up, I was number 6 on the list. And he told me if I would have re-enlisted for 2 years, they would have promoted me. Just waited for the paperwork to come through. They would have frocked me to 7. And I turned it down. I was like, nope, I got bigger fish to fry. I'd actually already been hired by another department, so.
Yep. Connor is wondering if there are any more road signs you're curious about.
Off the top of my head, not really. I know the national speed limit sign, that was one that confused me, and that's what I was wondering about, the multiple diagonal stripes instead of the thick diagonal stripe. It was a variant of the sign that I hadn't seen before. But other than that, I'm pretty good. Like I said, I lived in Korea for a year. I drove Korean roads, had my own car, that kind of thing. So, Korea, they drive on the right-hand side of the road, but their speed limits are all in kilometers per hour. All of their street signs are very European. For the most part, it's, if you can tell what the picture is, it does its job. Unlike in American signs. and going to American signs, and people's interpretation of them in America. I'm sure somebody else has heard it. The lady that called into the radio station saying that she'd called all kinds of people about the deer crossing sign in this area of the highway and how the deer shouldn't be crossing on the highway. And she'd talk however many people and senators and everything else, and I'm sitting there going, you've got to be kidding me.
She thought that we should move the sign so that the deer would cross somewhere else.
Right. It's what in the
And there's always there's always a joke about an old lady misinterpreting signs. One for sure, I'm gonna butcher it, but it was one day a trooper pulls over an old lady that was going about 3 or 4 times the speed of everybody else on the interstate or on the highway. He pulls her over, and there are 3 other old ladies in the car. He looks around and they look like they've just seen a ghost. They're scared, their hair is laying back, they're gripping the seats as tight as they can. And he says, ma'am, why were you going so fast? She says, well, what do you mean? I was going the speed limit. I said, no, ma'am, the speed limit on here is 70 miles an hour. I said, oh, well, I saw the sign back there that said 124.
Oh, the highway number. Hey, John O'Neill's asking, how were you introduced to the game?
To this game? Or?
Yep.
Believe it or not, and I said this in my video, I was and still am, I don't play it nearly as much as I want to, mainly because I'm doing stuff here and I got a whole bunch of irons in the fire. But anyway, I was playing World of Warcraft and I was really getting burnt out on the latest expansion of the time, Warlords of Draenor. And one of the games I was playing World of Warcraft with, man, it says, guy, you gotta check out American Truck Sim. And I told him, I was like, really? No. Now, put me in a real truck, I'd probably enjoy it. I love driving. But a simulator, come on. It'd be like watching paint dry. You know, I mean, just... And I watched a couple videos of it, and he kept telling me, man, you've really got to try this. You'd enjoy it. No, not so much. Well, one day I was poking around, and I saw it on Steam for $12 or $15 or something like that. So I grabbed it. Said, okay, he wants me to try it. I'll try it. And I played it for like 6 hours with a keyboard, and I'm like, oh, I didn't even know what time it was. My wife was like, are we going to eat dinner tonight? Yeah, give me a minute. So I got off the game, went and made dinner, and came back and sat down on the game for basically the rest of the night. And was like, I cannot believe how addictive that is. I bet you would be better with a controller. I got up the next day and started playing the game with keyboard. By the time I was like rank 11 or 12, I mean, overnight, just go, 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 go. Well, I need to get to this level. It might unlock something that I could put on my truck that would look cool, you know. And next thing you know, I'm sitting there, another 4 hours have gone by, and I'm like, oh, to hell with this. I told my wife, I was like, I'm going to Walmart. She says, for what? I was like, I got to buy a controller. And so I bought a controller, and I started playing with the controller and getting it all set up. And then I wondered about other people's controller layouts. And that's when I came across Bay Area Bugs. And watched some of his videos. And I hear him talking about his wheel. And I'm like, hang on a second. That's right, they make wheels for computers. So I started watching his. And then that led me to Squirrel, because he brought Squirrel up in one of his videos. And I was watching Squirrel drive a pixel truck as well as anybody I've ever seen in a real truck. I mean, he's talking about, yeah, I got to put the trailer here to get there, blah, 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 blah. Did kind of a driver's academy, whole nine yards. And I was like, wow, these guys take this serious. I could get into this. So I was watching Bugs' videos. I was watching Squirrel's videos. I just back to back to back. And I never thought about doing any YouTube stuff myself, but, you know, I wanted to be as, I guess, good at the game as I could be. And then I was looking at Bay Area Bugs' stuff, and I kept seeing this LSPDFR and SAPDFR, and I'm like, who are these other guys? And lo and behold, I saw Jeff, I watched Jeff's videos, and was like, wow, that guy, I can tell he's never been a cop, but he's pretty damn close. And I happen to follow Jeff on Twitter, on my personal Twitter. Now I actually just use Runt Gaming. But anyway, I saw on Twitter one day that he had a Discord and that he invited people in to come chat with him. And it ended up, it was, you know, I got on the computer, jumped in, and lo and behold, there's Jeff Faviano, the guy that I've been watching his videos, and he and I talked. We, you know, there at that time, there was only probably maybe 50 people total in his server. And it wasn't really announced publicly yet. The YouTube announcement hadn't come out. And sure enough, he and I started talking and carrying on. I gave him a couple pointers about what I thought he was doing right, what I thought that was a little hairy that might go a little bit better if he tried it this way or whatever. He says, hey, man, you've got a really good grip on this stuff. And we started talking. That's when I let him know that I am a former police officer. And he's like, oh, really? He says, man, you really ought to take what you know and translate it to GTA 5 and LSPDFR. And I said, man, it'd be just, people wouldn't like it, especially in today's climate. I appreciate the vote of confidence. And he talked at me, and he talked at me, and he talked at me. Finally, when the Discord announcement came out on YouTube, and Shock was there that first night, it was, all these kids were asking questions, and I was able to give them answers. And that's when I realized that the community is bigger than it seems. And if I can reach out to just a few young people and change their opinions about how police officers are, and, you know, or even interest them in the job of law enforcement, then it's worth it. And Jeff and I talked about, you know, me doing a YouTube thing, and he says, we'll try to make a couple videos, I'll watch them and, you know, see what I think. And that's when we started looking. He's like, oh, your video card, I can't do it, man. I want to watch your videos. I think you have a good presentation style, but your videos, the quality just sucks. And the community bound together, and I think Shock was there the night that the person offered me the money to get the video card I currently have, and was like, wow, really? Amazing. And so I ordered the video card and power supply, and the rest is history. And that's kind of where I'm at today, is I got playing American Truck Sim multiplayer online, and because I'm familiar enough with American laws, I wanted to go outside of my expertise level, so I got Euro Truck, and you know, American Truck, Euro Truck, pretty much same thing, minus different scenery, and different styles of truck, and the way they're driven, and everything else. It's fantastic. So hopefully that wasn't too long-winded and drawn out, but...
Well, I think you answered the question. Antonio Floyd says, hey, and Sherlock Holmes says they should add traffic to ETS2. It would make it a lot more difficult.
Well, ETS2 does have traffic, just like American Truck Sim does. However, multiplayer does not. It's a sync issue, if I'm not mistaken. Manley might be able to back me up on that one.
I'm not really sure what it is. I haven't actually read into why the developers say they haven't done it.
Well, like I said, I think it'd be a sync issue. I mean, it's hard enough to keep track of all the different moving people.
It's either a sync issue or something to do with the game engine.
I would more or less lean to a sync issue, because you would think that, you know, even though STS is a good company, their server capacities aren't necessarily the best for handling that type of, you know, movement and handling that type of traffic, literally.
Well, you think about the scenery being generated and everything else, and every once in a while we blink at each other.
Yeah.
So, I mean, trying to get... It would be like if you watch my video... of the heist I did with Pampered Duchess, and then you watch hers, and you see cars just kind of popping in and stuff like that. And it was mainly because of a lag issue. She was, and I don't know, I know she's not running on a potato, and I know where she lives, she's got decent internet. I don't know what the deal was with her connection, but I mean, roads weren't there. Bridges wouldn't render, but yet she's driving over them, so it looks like she's flying through thin air. I think it's more of a sync issue, personally. Mm-hmm. Now, one of the things that I would like to see SCS bring in is the ability to... Oh, I can buy my truck. What about me buying a trailer? If I want to haul stuff just in a box van. And I can have the box van painted to match my truck. Or if I want to get a flatbed, or, you know, whatever. And open it up that way, where instead of going to get loads that are already trailered, I basically have to put my box van into a loading dock to pick up my cargo and leave. Which would, from my understanding, a lot more realistic as far as real truck driving goes.
Good evening. Sirius is in.
Yay.
What's up, Sirius?
Continued my fight with Windows 10. It updated again last night after I finished getting it working, and then the fix wouldn't work, so I had to uninstall the Windows 10 update. So it's been a nightmare.
RIP.
Had to slap it right in the penis.
Not the fans.
That's right.
I hope everybody enjoys that.
Yeah.
Yep.
By the way, Sirius, I'm streaming.
Oh.
Oh, man.
On Twitch?
No. YouTube. Oh. I just decided to throw a video up real quick on... Or do a video real quick.
Whoops. I do apologize.
Yeah, no problem.
Sorry, guys.
No. But, no, as soon as I get done with this load, 43 miles an hour, and I'm flying through town.
Oh, shoot. You might hear a distress call.
Who else on there with you?
Just Manly.
Oh, okay. Heck, everybody was talking. I figured you were just talking. I didn't know you were actually gaming and recording.
Well, I'm technically not recording. I'm just streaming.
Well, YouTube automatically just puts it up there after you're done, right?
Yeah. Now these guys get to watch.
Is anybody even watching?
Yeah, there's 20. 20 right now.
On a Friday night. They're probably like, how come we hear other people?
Because we're all hanging out in my sanctuary. And here's the thing. I've been thinking, guys, about opening up my personal Discord server to everybody. The thing that's holding me back is I don't want anybody to get butt hurt.
Mayday.
Mayday, Manly.
Did you kill your truck?
Yeah.
Getting those scissors, pasty white hands.
There it is.
I can't believe I said that on the live stream.
That's what makes live TV so interesting. And I'm going to try to... Oh, I'm going to try to sneak this in there. Like so.
I don't think anybody was paying attention, so... Chat doesn't seem to.
Yeah, but now if you say that, everyone's going to be like, oh, what did he say?
Yep. Rewind.
Going back and trying to figure it
out. Well, I actually have it set up on YouTube where... crank the wheel over harder. Have it set up to where they could actually... It runs like a DVR.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it.
Uh-oh.
There it is. You heard what he said. Oh. Oh, dear.
Oh, my.
Oh, my.
Oh, my.
Oh, my. This is a disgrace.
Oh. Dragging that trailer around that corner.
Is that a runt grunt I just heard?
Yep, that was a runt grunt. That was a...
The Manly Mayday and the runt grunt.
Mm-hmm.
Serious, my apologies for my previous comments.
Was not aware that we were live.
Yeah. I heard it. Be careful, YouTube will have you. Yeah, demonetized.
Hashtag demonetized.
People say worse stuff on YouTube all the time.
Yeah. Alright. There's that. We'll wait for...
Now, let's see if I can do the same thing with a controller.
Colin Beaver says, I can't speak. It's fine. I have heard worse. My dad was a sailor. I mean, yeah. Pretty much.
Alrighty. I've shut down this rattle truck of mine and sit here. Yeah, good luck with that other corner. You'll end up dragging the trailer.
Serious,
around.
How do you like his paint job on his truck?
Yeah. I love that.
America.
What was that, Ruck?
Love it.
Nice.
Now just gotta straighten this thing up.
The truck of American food.
Uh oh, man, like your favorite fan is in here.
Yep.
Do what?
Nothing.
Is the truck strobing, or am I seeing things?
Well, I can make mine do that too.
Well, since I'm hauling chemicals, I've got the beacons on.
Oh, okay, that's what it is. Yep. You got ELS?
ATS ELS, there it is. Confirmed.
Confirmed.
Confirmed mod.
Hashtag Illuminati.
You're gonna be out next month. We're doing a beta test.
More like hashtag Illuminati.
Illuminati.
Hashtag epileptic seizure.
Hashtag having a stroke.
Oh, look at that.
This is the most people you've ever had doing a live stream.
Oh, yeah, 27.
Oh,
the
nice.
The truck made from a flag has flags on it. Extreme America.
Yep.
And I got 80 grand for that.
Yep.
All right, we're good to go.
Yep. I hate to do it, guys, but this is going to be the end of the live stream. That was a long enough episode. I'm going to have some fun with my other friends, but not live stream it. We're going to be going over to the American Truck Sim multiplayer server. So if you got American Truck Sim, jump in and make a run with us. Don't know exactly where we're going to be yet, but we'll be in there, I'm pretty sure, won't we, Sean?
Yeah.
Manly, you in?
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, we're out of here, so I got to kill it this way or my computer will have a fit, so... So now you guys get a good picture of my desktop, and we're out of here, guys. Thanks for stopping by. It's been fun. I'll talk to y'all later. Bye now.